Hi, it's me again with Crow Roll Tips and Tricks. Somebody posted this on Facebook. They just really asked how to cut the letters out, not to do the border, but I'm going to show both because it's... So yeah, I've got a... I didn't have this text. I don't know what that text is. I just picked abstract groovy. So take your text and just left click no fill and right click red and make sure it's a hairline, and those will cut out. That's a hairline in your... You say you did mention you had Corel. Just put that in your laser and make it whatever size you want to cut out. Now, if you do want to cut it out and place it, you would want to cut this out of another piece of wood so it'd be different colored. I am going to go in and go create a boundary. Whoop. Well, that'll work. I'm going to move it up, and then I'm going to left click. No fill, right click outline. That's actually exactly what I wanted because I just wanted the boundary. But I did not move it, I nudged it. I'm actually gonna nudge it up one more time to get it out of there. Now, we can go to object, or excuse me, go to effects and contour, and we're gonna contour to the outside. Since that's that big, I'm going to contour 1 inch with rounded corners and hit apply. Not quite enough. So let's go 2 inches. You know what? I think I had my number locked, so maybe it didn't do a half inch. That's not quite enough. So let's do 2 inches and hit apply. That's a little bit too much. We're getting too much definition. Or not enough definition. So it's like 1.5 inches. Still not enough. Let's go 1.2. Man, normally you're gonna get more offset than that. Maybe it's because, well, in this case, we've got some lowercase text. Let me pick another font and actually, I was helping somebody the other day, and now I've got the same problem. I need to adjust this where it doesn't have no uniform fill. There we go. And then I can right click. Well, actually, I'm going to right click fill. So it's still a font. It's Arial. I'm going to take that now. I'm going to look at another font. That doesn't look too bad. So same thing here. Just left click, right click. Now make sure it's a hairline. And a lot of times you have to click off of it and actually go up to object and convert it to a curve. And then you're going to get that it's a hairline. So that worked. Now we're going to contour the exact same amount. And see, now we're getting a more definite piece of wood. So now what you're going to do is take the object, break contour apart, and I would move the outside. I'll tell you what, let me nudge it down. And I would also not have that gap. So you need to go to object and break the curve apart and get that gap out of there. And then let's say you do this out of wood that, well, let's make a lighter wood. Let's make it like that color. I'm going to go ahead and take away the outline for a second. So that's the way the wood would look. And then here, you don't have to do anything. You don't have to color it because you're going to paint it. And then just, so you would, you know, get a piece of wood, you know, a different color wood. I'm using somebody else's file and it's actually filling in. That would bug me to no end. So now just take the, so you're going to cut this. Well, let's tell you, we can move it because we're going to paint it. So cut that out and make, you know, make the wood as small as you can. And just cut that out of your piece of wood. And let's say, that would bug me to no end. Let's just take the smart fill tool. Settle on another color wood. Let's go with that brown there. Now, I did move it. So that's what your wood's gonna look like cut. I'm gonna take away all the outline. And see, it's still got a box around it. Yep, I'm gonna remove the box. I just converted to curve. I'd go ahead and group those together and then just place it in there. Now, a little bit of, and that would be pretty easy, but think about this when you're doing this. Let's take, and let's make a duplicate of that. Let's take this and make a duplicate and nudge it down. And I'm going to left click, right click. You can actually, you know, if I didn't move it, it would be perfect. You could actually score the wood with a vector because you're going to cut this out. So this exact thing, I'm going to take away all the color. So, and I'm not exactly where I need to be, but let's take all this out of the way. And you could actually use color mapping on this, but you don't have to. So what I would do, and that's quite large, but let's make your piece of wood. And let's say your wood is this big. Boy, that would bug me to no end. Anyway, so what you're going to do is move that out of the way. And I'm going to group this together, Control G, and I'm going to nudge it up. I would put this back in. Well, you would actually probably do the other first. Because we've nudged, we can put it right back. You're not going to cut the outside line, so we're going to just delete it. And run this as a vector job, like at 100 speed and 100 power. And it will not cut through the wood, but it'll mark the wood. And then take that away and bring this in and cut it out at whatever it's going to take to cut out your wood, you know, 100 power at 15 speed, 10 speed, whatever it takes to get through the thickness of your wood. Because this is going to help you set, let me group this together. So when you're through and you've got this mark, it's going to be a lot easier to glue the wood to the item. Like I'm even having trouble right now. But if you move your, I don't want to move that one. I want to move the brown. See, and then you're perfect. You're perfect where you're at. Now, in this particular font, I would have fixed this before I contoured it. See what it did? And so that's, to me, that's a bad look. But that's very easily fixed. We could left click, right click, and go ahead and fix that C with the shape tool. You got to break it apart. Click on it, go up to object, ungroup it, grab the shape tool. Let's just get rid of those nodes. Seeing there's actually two sets of nodes there. That's a lot of times you happen when you do that. Let's go up to object. Well, so to get rid of, we've got double nodes. So you could either delete, that's actually the one that wants. So we're just gonna move them down. And the eye's got a little bit of a funny problem, but that's gonna look a lot better. Let's go ahead and do this. I normally don't like my videos being this long, but let's put a border around it, and that's fine. I'm going to left click, right click. And the reason that's happening is the file I'm using from somebody, they have fill. And then I'm going to go to effects and contour. We're going to contour that same amount. See, now the difference, that C is all clear where this is not. So always look for stuff like that when you're going to contour. The contour is going to amplify it so it'd be more noticeable, but you can always back up. Anyway, I hope that helped a little bit. Thank you for watching.